Now, every time you defeat a group of enemies, another wave comes. I'm telling y'all, that's how we operate in this earth. Every time we defeat one wave of demons and devils, another wave comes.
Yes, yes.
We go through the abortion thing. Then you got the homosexuality thing. Then you got the hate thing. Every time throughout the body of Christ, we defeated a wave of enemies, another wave comes. And God says, you have to fortify your position in me. Okay, you got over pornography. You got over lying and stealing. Fortify. Because the next round, adultery is coming at you. Divorce is coming at you. And you fought that off. Fortify. Because in the next round, sickness is coming at you. Okay, you beat sickness. Fortify. Build yourself up. Because the next round, confusion is coming at you. Okay, you beat confusion. The next round, this is coming, that's coming. God is saying the only way you're going to be able to survive in this day and age and be effective and disciple people is if you have to do that from the vine. You have to be so connected to me and not your agenda, me and not your social media status, me and not your brand. A lot of people ain't going to like that. God tired of all these brands. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. It's but one brand I represent, and that's Jesus Christ in the spirit. What I have to say is of no importance because what I get is from God.
Yes.
If he don't say it, I don't say it. So I'm saying it again. God is sick of all these brands. When y'all gonna point them to me? When y'all gonna point them to me? Because guess what? As soon as the person in that position falls, great is the fall of that individual. I'm going to talk about it because he put it out there. I'm going to talk about it. And I don't know the situation, but God is a restorer. We're going to talk about Israel and New Breed. We're going to talk about it. Awesome songs. Awesome songs. And I like what he wrote. He said, I failed in my personal life. Y'all, it's not that you don't make mistakes. Can you own up to it? But do you all know, even if he wasn't trying to do that, there's some people that got so caught up into the man that it swayed their faith? Man, Israel cheated on his wife. I am a friend. Listen, y'all, people make mistakes. That's why your brand don't matter. His brand is what matters. And I'm not knocking nobody's brand so long as they represent the king. Don't get so caught up in people that you lose sight of God. Can God talk to you?
Come on, come on.
Man, we got people all up here. Can God talk to you? And God is showing me that. Amen?
Amen.
Let's go here. Look at verse 5. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do what? Nothing. Come on, stay with me. Verse 5. I am the vine and you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do what? Nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered. And they gather them and throw them into the fire and they are burned. See, when you're withered, that means you're fading. This is what withered means. When you're withered, that means you're fading, you're decaying, or you're losing your freshness. So watch this. If he is the vine and we are the branches, and he who abides in me and I am bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. Watch this. If you don't abide in God, right, if you're not so in his face, if you're not praying, if you're not fasting, if you're not in his word, whether I tell you to or not, whether apostle tell you to or not, if you're not in his word, you're going to get to a point where you're cast out as a branch. And you're withered. And what do they do with the ones that are withered? They gather them together, they throw them into the fire, and they burn. Because when you're withered, that means you're fading. You're decaying. You're getting old. You're losing your freshness. The only way a flower can wither is if it's not being watered. If you ever felt like you're withering away, allow the water of the word to restore your freshness.
Jesus.
I'm telling that to somebody today. Jesus. If ever you're feeling like you're withering away, you're decaying, or you're losing your freshness, allow the water of the word to restore you. Let's look here at verse 7. I'm coming to a close right here. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. So y'all don't even get that scripture. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciples. The reason you can ask and it will be done for you is because when you're abiding in him, you're in a place of production. Mm-hmm. Remember, the branches that abide in the vine produce much fruit. So the reason you can ask and it's given to you is because you're producing. A lot of people are not producing, but they're asking. Got laid on a job. He's supposed to make 10 sandwiches in an hour. He making 3. He talking about, I need a raise. Okay, let's check what you're doing. Come here. Come on, leave me in the office. Come on. Sit down. Is your name Hakeem? Is your partner named Sammy? Okay, check this out. You've been here 2 hours, you're supposed to make 20 burgers. But you made 6. And you've been late. And you want what? A raise. I want more. I want more money. A lot of people have been asking, but they ain't producing. And when you don't produce, you don't get. But look how the devil spin it and put it back. Look how the devil indict God. And you shall ask what you will, and it shall be. I'm coming before you, Lord. Produce before me. I'm laying and praying. Produce before me. God is telling some people in here to produce. Because look what the word says. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. Because he who abides in me, as the prior verse says, bears much fruit. The reason that you can ask and it will be done is because when you're abiding, you're in a place of production. You want to know why athletes get paid so much? It's because they produce results. CEOs, tycoons, any position of prominence is because they can produce. And when you produce, they pay you the big bucks. As we come to a close, you want God to bless you beyond measure? Start producing more fruit. You want God to bless you beyond measure? Start producing more fruit. But when you produce, make sure you're doing it from the vine. As we stand to our feet, when you produce, make sure you're doing it from the vine, y'all. You can't do it in and of your own self. You can't do it in and of your own theology. You can't do it in and of your own schemes and your